Thank you, Maria Rosa. It's a pleasure to participate in today's discussion. As I was saying before, I can't say that I'm a big fan of teleworking. I love people better than not to talk on this important subject. And I'd like to start with a more general picture, with international picture, with global picture, and then move more precisely to the work EU is doing and what we expect from the EU. Everybody's repeating that a good crisis should not be wasted. And when we talk about digital topics, I would argue that this pandemic has brought it high on political agenda from different perspectives. Teleworking, e-education, digital services, but also the questions of cybersecurity. Starting with cybersecurity generally, we see the increased number of attacks by state-sponsored actors on critical infra, on hospitals. We see that the number of cyber attacks has dramatically increased. But also we see that cybersecurity has a human face. Each and every one of us is a cybersecurity expert today, when we go online and when we do the most elementary things. So I would argue that cyber literacy, cyber hygiene has also become part of cybersecurity and should be taken as seriously as cybersecurity on a state, government, and international arena. Today, when we talk in Brussels or wherever we are in our capitals, in our cities, there is also an event going to be in New York, where New York will wake up. Secretary General will launch his roadmap for digital cooperation. We know that United Nations are discussing in different working groups, UNGG, an open-ended working group, questions of cybersecurity, peace and stability. We know that Secretary General has launched his peace initiative, and it seems very logical to expand it to cyber peace or digital peace. So a lot is happening globally. I'm not naive. I don't think that United Nations will be to agree on anything specific and binding in the coming future because of ideological division. Here I see a role for the EU. Now we come to the EU, and I'd like to approach it from two aspects. First, EU as a global player. When we see the number of increased cyber attacks and when we see response to attackers, I would argue that there is no other global leader like EU can be and should be. United States having its internal problems, not having cybersecurity so high on agenda anymore, and not being so vocal on cybersecurity. More cyber power from Russia, China, some other countries, it all puts pressure on the EU. And I would say that we have excellent tools at our hands. We have the same understanding. We have Cybersecurity Act. We have cyber diplomacy toolbox. We have the means. Now it's time to start finally applying them and going more into practice. And when I say going more into practice, I mean attribution, accountability, and countermeasures. And now finally, what we can and should do within the EU. I very much recognize endeavors towards and coordinated EU response to cybersecurity challenges. The ambitions are out there. Political documents are most correct ones, saying right things. Now it's the question of applicability and of upgrading the existing laws, regulations we have. I think it's very important to review NIS directive. I think it's very important to start working on the new cybersecurity strategy, although I have to admit there are some questions. For example, for me, the new cybersecurity unit raises questions. How is it going to cooperate with the already existing PESCO project, cyber rapid response teams and mutual assistance in cybersecurity? So there are questions, but it's the right time to start answering them. And from the European Parliament perspective, I'm a newcomer to the European Parliament, but I see that my colleagues in the European Parliament are taking digital topics and cybersecurity more and more seriously. For example, today, as the member of the LIBE committee, I'm working on the Digital Services Act. I'm a shadow for Digital Services Act. And I think that today nobody questions that the digital single market will only be effective if there is trust that the products, services, and processes provide an adequate level of cybersecurity. So I'm very much looking forward to hearing from Juhan, because ENISA here has a crucial role, and I very much think that certification and cyber standards should be and can be the same success story as GDPR has been for the EU. And I consider GDPR a success story today. And my final remark, I would also raise the question of digital ID. I do not see that digital topics or digital agenda could be 100% effective or can serve our people without digital identification. The same identification system as we have offline. Of course, it has to be secure, it has to be trusted by people, it has to be harmonized all over EU to make it workable. But I also think that it's time to start talking about digital ID. In the end, all the topics we're going to discuss today, they are good if they are political documents, but they need implementation and they need trust. Trust on all levels. Trust between government, states and private sector, citizens, private sector, consumers, private sector. And I'm a very strong supporter of cooperation, and I'm a very strong supporter of multi-stakeholder model. So I'll stop here and I look forward to the discussion.